Today we will discuss about the research partners testing machine. And these are the specifications of the research partners testing machine available in our test load ranges are given 5 kilogram force, 10 kilogram force, 20 kilogram force, 30 kilogram force, and 50 kilogram force. In this, we are performing the experiment with the 30 kilogram force as the load. Then magnification of optical measurement device 20 meters, 140 meters. The maximum test height is 230 millimeters. Least count on the scale, measuring scale 0.001 millimeter. Cross depth 135 millimeter. Then machine dimensions, weight of the machine 70 kilograms, etc. Now coming to the machine. This is the Vickers Partners testing machine available in our lab. You can see this one. This is kept in an enclosed area so as to protect it from dust and other things. And on this, you can see this is the loading area. This is actually a platform over which the specimen is mounted. And here it is coming with the, it is consisting of two vertical tubes or cylinders, you can see. And the first one is just like a telescope for viewing the specimen as well as the indentation made on that one. And the second one, this is actually the indenter. These are actually kept at 90 degrees with each other, so that by rotating this base plate on which these two are fixed, we can bring the indenter or the telescope over the indentation directly. Then, on this machine, you can see some switches provided on the side. This is the switch which is controlling the light that is available on the loading area. So, by switching this one, you can put the light on. And on the side of this platform, there is another switch which will control the supply onto the machine. So, first you have to switch on this switch. Then you have to switch on the switch that is provided on the side of the machine directly for putting on the light on the loading area. Right. Then, on the front side of the machine, you can view this one. There are two switches, one yellow switch as well as one green switch available. And this green switch is the starting switch. That is, if you push the blue button, the machine will get started and automatically loading will take place on the specimen that is kept on the loading platform. And after the decided or tuned time lapse, that is 5 seconds, 6 seconds, 10 seconds, etc. After you put on the loading, after completing that time lapse, so automatically the loading will be cut and the will be released. And while cutting the loader, this particular blue light will become on. Then for conducting the experiment, first you have to switch on the light on the loading area. Then, remove that, take it out. This is actually the portion of the machine. So as the height available is not sufficient, we are keeping another piece of the mild steel specimen over that one. So it will be like this, so that the space in between the loading platform and the indenter will be minimized. And this is actually the specimen. It is a cylindrical portion with a very small height. So that is inserted. Now the telescope is coming above the specimen, so that through the telescope we can view and the image can be obtained on the machine through this particular slit that the light is coming there. And you have to view if there are some indentations already made on the specimen, is visible or not. and if it is visible, you have to relocate it where there is no indentation coming on the surface. And to view it, that is why the light is kept in the opposite direction, opposite face.
No, 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 no.
So, just by raising the platform over which the specimen is kept, you view it through the telescope. First, initially, telescope is kept over the surface. Okay. Indenter is kept outside surface. So, by viewing or simply by lowering and raising the platform, you can keep that in the focal plane of the telescope so that the image will be visible clearly on the screen of the instrument. You can see the light that is falling on the platform through the telescope. So in the place that is coming immediately below that light will be reflected in the screen that is kept on the front side of the machine. So that should be kept in the appropriate position correctly, then only that light will be seen in the screen. So if there are some indentations coming immediately below the telescope, that will be viewed as a dark portion in the screen.
Right?
So now you can see it has a bright that light without any dark portion, so there is no indentation coming immediately below the telescope. Okay. Now the platform may be raised. Platform may be, for example, telescope may be replaced by the indenter by rotating this lever. So now indenter is coming immediately above the specimen. After that, you by rotating this lowering platform with the lever provided at the bottom, you keep the specimen in just contact with the indenter as shown here. Right? So just keep the indenter to be in contact with the surface of the specimen whose hardness is to be tested. Just like that. So when you feel some pressure while rotating this lever, you can stop. And after that, this is the screen, right? Okay. Now what is to be done is that you have to lower it by pressing the green button, and here it is set as 6 seconds, you know, 6 seconds as the time or time lapse for lowering. So after 6 seconds, it will automatically, this yellow light will go on and the loading will cut. So you can see that. Yeah. So it is loading. Sorry. Now the loading is cut. And you can show the picture. So after that, the loading may be removed by lowering the platform. After that, the position of the telescope may be brought immediately above the specimen on which the indentation is already made by the indenter. So, by looking through the telescope, you can view the indentation on the screen as a diamond shape. Usually, the diameter is just like a right circular square pyramid. So you can get the square as an integration with the diagonals horizontal as well as vertical. Right? Now what is to be done is that the average diagonal of the indentation should be measured in millimeter, and for which the scale that is available on this screen may be used. You can see on the screen there are certain graduations. So on the screen the distance between two adjacent large lines will be 1 millimeter, 1 millimeter actually. And in that itself you can see that here at the middle one graduation is again subdivided into 10 divisions, so that 10 division, that one small division will be equal to 0.1 millimeter. And on this side you can see a vernier is available here on that 100 division surface, so that 0.01 millimeter is again subdivided into 100 divisions here. So totally the least count of this one as shown in the brochure, that will be equal to 0.001 millimeter. That means 1 millimeter is subdivided into 1000 divisions ultimately. Now you may bring on this screen there are two scales sliding one over the other one, and at the center you can see the vertical large line, at the top you can see 10 graduation there, and the bottom also there is 10 graduation, right, bottom, and the top is one scale sliding over another one with the zero at the bottom scale. So you can see that one. While rotating this this one, you can see that it is sliding. Right, sliding. Now it is not coinciding. So by rotating that vernier on the outside, you rotate that one until the 0-0 will coincide. 0-0 coincide here. 0-0 coincide here. 0-0 should coincide, right? Before measuring the diagonal, the 0-0 should coincide so that this also will become equal to 0. 0. So these three zeros, what is it? Now it is all right. See, these two vertical lines are coinciding, it is 0-0. Two vertical lines on two sliding scales will coincide, and also this reading will be 0. This is the initial setup. 0-0. Yes, this is the initial setup before measuring the diagonal. After that, by rotating another screw that is provided at the bottom of the screen, you make one vertical line coinciding with the one end of one diagonal, horizontal diagonal of the indentation as shown in figure. You can see indentation is coming at the this is the indentation, diamond shape. Right? You make one vertical line of the scale coinciding with one end of the diagonal of the scale, and after that by rotating the vernier scale, vernier that is provided on the outer side, you rotate appropriately in such a way that another line will coincide the other end of the same diagonal, right? Other end of the same diagonal. Other end of the same diagonal, right? Now we can view also. This is the diagonal. So one vertical line will be in contact with the the one vertical line is in contact with the one end, and another vertical line is in contact with the other diagonal. So that two vertical lines are coming at the ends of one diagonal. So in between here, one full graduation. One full graduation here, and another full graduation here, and in between there is a fraction stem. So the one full graduation that is measuring actually 0.1 millimeter. So here it is coming 0.2 plus a fraction, and you can also measure what is the fraction coming on the graduation, small graduation section. It is coming as 5. That is at the middle. In the video, it is not very clear. But the graduations can be measured directly from the screen. So here it is 5, and if you view the vernier that is kept outside, you can view it as almost 0. 0 is done. So here the total reading will be 0.25 millimeter. If fraction is coming here, that may be coming as the third digit. So this diagonal is 0.23 millimeter, and also you have to measure the other diagonal for which this may be rotated. This may be rotated in the 90 degree direction, and again in a similar way you can measure the distance or length of the vertical diagonal and get the average of it. So that will be coming as the D in millimeter. So this is the experimental measurement you have to make, or experimentally these are the things which are you have to perform, right? Yeah, this will be like this. Indentation is coming shown seen as a square with the one diagonal vertical, and in a similar way you measure the corresponding length of the diagonal, right? So this is the thing what we have to do experimentally, and after measuring the diagonal in the textbook, the procedure is given very clearly. Yeah, this is the indenter. This is the indenter. It is just like a square pyramid. Good angle between two opposite faces of the indenter is equal to 135 degrees. So you will get an indentation like this, and we are measuring this D1 and D2 in millimeter, and after getting D1 and D2, D is taken as the average of D1 and D2 in diameter, and the hardness number is determined as applied load divided by area of indentation. So substituting the appropriate values, that will be approximately equal to 1.854 f by d square. That is obtained by considering the included angle between the opposite faces of the indenter. That is, HB is calculated as the force divided by area, that is equal to 2 into f sine theta by 2, 2 into f sine theta by 2 divided by d square. Force divided by area. So actually area is equal to d square divided by 2 sine theta by 2, and rearranging you get it like this. For f is the force applied in kilogram, and theta is equal to 135 in our case, and d is the average diagonal length of the indentation, right? And f is equal to 30 kilogram force for our experiment, and we are retaining that 30 kilogram force for a period of 5 to 6 seconds. And this HV is represented as the vitreous hardness, and that is written, vitreous hardness number is written like this, HV 30 by 5. HV stands for, H stands for hardness, V for vitreous. So HV suppose that it is the vitreous hardness number, it is again number, and 30 is obtained as the number from this expression 2f sin theta by 2 by d square, means 30 by 5. 5 is the time in seconds which is retained on the specimen after started the load. So the vicious hardness number is represented in this code, HV30/5, where 30 is not the, actually this HV30/5 is written after the number, hardness number. The hardness number is obtained as a 10. The HV will be written as 10 HV 30/5. So 10 is the hardness number, HV is the vickers hardness, 30 is the load applied, and 5 is the time in seconds that the load retained on the specimen. So this is the format in which the hardness number is to be presented.